person to ask her to step in here for a minute. Let me see how to is Raskolnikov in there? Has he come? Yeah, he is the widow of a legion and has come to try and get a pension and to fray out her skirts in the government offices. Because at 50 she paints her face, everybody knows it. A creature like that did not think fit to come and does not even answer the invitation which the most ordinary good manners required. I can't understand why Pyotr Petrovich has not come. But where's Sonia? Where's she gone? Ah! There she is at last. What is it, Sonia? Where have you been? It's odd that even at your father's funeral you should be so unpunctual. Rodion Romanovich, make room for her beside you. That's your place, Sonia. Take what you like. Have some of the cold entree curiously at him. But for the rest of the time, she seemed to avoid looking at him and speaking to him. She seemed absent-minded, though she kept looking at Katerina Ivanovna, trying to please her. She'll say now. And he set off in the direction of Sonia's lodgings. Chapter 4. Raskolnikov had been a vigorous and active champion of Sonia. Only don't talk to me, as you did yesterday, she interrupted him. Please don't begin. There is misery enough without that. She made haste to smile, afraid that he might not like the reproach. I was silly, boy, as Leonard Yakovlev would say. He was beginning to lose the thread. No, really, I'm serious. Imagine, Sonia, that you had known all Lucian's intentions before. This is to be mixed up in it. There's no doing anything, Raskolnikov grumbled morosely. You'd better say straight out what you want, Sonia cried in distress. You are leading up to something again. Can you have come simply to torture me? She could not control herself and began crying, but asked Sonia, dreadfully frightened. He could not utter a word. This was not at all the way he had intended to tell. And he did not understand what was happening to him now. She asked again, hardly audibly, and again after a minute's pause. He turned to her and looked amazed that she had really foreseen this very thing. Stop, Sonia, enough. Don't torture me, he begged her miserably. Decided whether to take that money or not, he said, musing again. And seeming to wake up with a start, he gave a brief, ironical smile. Yeah. What silly stuff I'm talking, eh? The thought flashed through Sonia's mind. Wasn't he mad? But she dismissed it at once. No, it was something else. She could make nothing of it, nothing. Do you know, Sonia? He said, suddenly with conviction. Let me tell you. Take note of that. It may explain a great deal. I have come because I am bad. There are men who wouldn't have come, but I am a coward and a mean wretch. But never mind, that's not the point. I must speak now, but I don't know how to begin. He paused and said, Phantom. They destroy men by millions themselves and look on it as a virtue. They are knaves and scoundrels. Sonia, I am not going to them. And what should I say to them? That I murdered her, but did not dare to take the money and hid it under a stone? He added with a bitter smile. Why, they would laugh at me and would call me a fool for not a burden to bear. And your whole life, your whole life. I shall get used to it, he said grimly and thoughtfully. Listen, he began a minute later. Stop crying. It's time to talk of the facts. I've come to tell you that the police are after me on my track. Sonia cried in terror. Well, why do you cry out? You want me to go to Siberia and now you are frightened? But let me tell you, I shall not give my...
Block it, Blavinger!
She pointed to a man in the crowd. It's all because Kolya here is so stupid. I have such a bother with him.
What do you want? Polka? Tell me in French, Paribas, Francais. Why, I've taught you, you know some phrases. Those howling to show that you are of good family, well brought up children, and not at all like other organ grinders. We aren't going to have a Punch and Judy show in the street, but to sing a genteel song. Yes, well, and then we shall go to Nevsky, where there are far more people of good society, and we shall be noticed at once.
Lena knows my village only, nothing but my village, and everyone sings that.
We must sing something far more genteel.
Well, have you thought of anything, Polenka? He ceased for a time. She looked with sick but intent and penetrating eyes at Sonia, who stood pale and trembling, wiping the sweat from her brow with a handkerchief. At last she asked to be raised, They sat her up on the bed, supporting her on all sides.
What are you doing?
He thought. Yet he felt at once that that was not the only cause of his uneasiness. There was something requiring immediate decision.